Standing by. Stopping this lap. Checks complete. All personnel be aware, we have a car leaving. this lap. So far, our fastest lap is a 1:32.4. When you're ready, let's go. but we need to warm the tyres properly now. Make sure you get some heat into the brakes as well. Rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. We'll be right back. approaching the pit window. You'll be on mediums. now. We'll be doing one more stop today. One stop left in our strategy. Resulting in loose debris. Fortunately, the marshals have managed to clear it up in time, and there are no plans for a safety car right now. Slow down, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. Our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Coming up to the safety car now. Do not pass it. You are the leader. Follow the safety car. approaching the safety car. You're leading, so don't pass it. Stay behind the safety car. Safety car is coming in this lap. We'll be pacing the field in sector 3. Make sure to respect the delta until the safety car is in the pit lane. can slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. This lap then, come into the pits at the end of this lap. Drop your speed, our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Exit now. We're racing on the exit. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. We're coming up to the safety car now. Do not pass it. You are the leader. Follow the safety car. safety car. You're leading, so don't pass it. Stay behind the safety car. Safety car is in this lap. Safety car in this lap. You'll be controlling the pace on the restart. Keep it steady until the safety car has reached the pit lane. of fuel remaining. We'll be right back.
or heavier in the last few laps, and I couldn't catch up to Blin and Val Newell, which, first of all, congrats to Charles on the championship, but I can't imagine what Blin is going through. I mean, I've come close in a couple of different leagues to getting championships, couldn't quite get them, but I've never lost one like this. So, but no, Blin, congrats on a great season nonetheless. And yeah, for me, it was a good way to end off the season.
Yeah, and you, I remember we spoke after you got the win, I think in Baku it was, and you were on a great run at that stage and sort of working your way back into the championship before a couple of not so great results at Zandvoort and Mexico. But so what are your thoughts about the season as a whole, and can we expect to see you back for season 13, and what are your expectations for that, if so?
Yeah, so I think the end result was good. I believe I'll end up third in points when it's all said and done. But at the same time, I think I had too high expectations going into the season, because the first half of my season was just slow. You know, I was back in seventh and eighth and really just couldn't do anything. And then it just clicked, you know, around Britain. I just got the hang of it, started winning races, but I just didn't have enough time, you know, and all it took was a couple of bad races at Zandvoort, Mexico, and, you know, the championship was out of reach. But yeah, I do plan on coming back. Hopefully I can be faster this season, possibly go for that championship. And yeah, we'll just see what happens.
Seafreeze, do you have anything to add for Camden?
Yeah, one question. Firstly, congrats on the podium. Coming into this race, you had the back of the grid penalty. Did you know the scenario, the situation Blin and Sir Charles were in tonight? And if so, how does that impact you ultimately trying to win your race for you individually? Do you want to get involved? Do you not want to get involved? How do you kind of deal with that if you did know the scenario?
Oh, I was totally aware. And it actually made me more excited. I really wanted to get up to Blin and kind of like, you know, not necessarily take the championship away from him, but it would be cool to kind of like be in that mix to like affect the championship. So it gave me a little bit more, you know, motivation to get up to the front. But yeah, I was totally aware. I checked the points before the race and I saw Charles wasn't going to make it. So it's like, ooh, if Blin wins, he could win the championship. And obviously I had a front row seat at that battle between he and Val Newell. And yeah, I was hoping to get to the front, but like I said, I just had way too much fuel in the tank.
Interesting. Well, yeah, good stuff. Thank you. Yeah, congrats on the podium, and we'll see you back here in season 13. Good job.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, thank you, Camden, for joining us and for a memorable season on your part. And now we're going to move on to the second place man today and the second place man in the championship as well, Blin Machine. Blin, I don't know what to say. That was such a great race from you. You held the lead for such a long time, withstood so much pressure at the end, and also earlier on making good calls with the strategy and with, you know, building out a gap once safety cars finished and everything. And then to lose it like that is pretty cruel, I must say. But you've had a fantastic season, it has to be said. And I don't quite know what to say. So I guess, you know, what a penny for your thoughts at this point, I suppose.
Yeah, I don't even know what to say, honestly. You know, if I would have lost it to Sir Charles on track, then it would have been fine, or anyone else that actually had any relation to the championship in the season. But Valid Newell, just completely irrelevant and just didn't even know, didn't have a clue about what was going on in the championship, which, you know, shows you clearly what's going on in that kid's mind. But I don't know. I mean, I played everything exactly right. I had the pace. I qualified on pole for the first time in the whole season. Like, when I needed it, I had everything I needed. And then, yeah, to lose it on the last lap by somebody that doesn't really know what's going on in the whole season, it's frustrating. But I don't know what else to say, honestly. Congrats to Sir Charles. It was a great season. He was an amazing teammate, and you know, we did everything we could throughout the season. Winning the Constructors' Championship definitely is nice. At least the Drivers' Championship is going to another McLaren driver as well. But yeah, really frustrating. I mean, second time in three seasons that I am the runner-up on this championship, and second time it's because of a driver that had no clue what was going on in the championship last season, or no, two seasons ago. It was Motown, or I can't remember exactly what his name was, but Motor City. He blocked me in Mexico from getting a podium, and that lost me a couple of points going into the finale, and then that was it in the finale as well. So yeah, I mean, if there's anything to learn from this situation, is that, you know, drivers that are driving in the league need to actually care what's going on in the league, need to actually, you know, pay attention to what's going on in standings and on track and things like that, because, you know, I don't think I did anything to Valley Newell throughout the season to deserve just kind of, you know, being taken away a championship like that on the last lap. So I hope he's happy with that. I hope he's enjoying himself with this empty win. And yeah, that's pretty much it.
I hear you, Lynn, and I feel very sorry for you, but I would say that, you know, everyone here is here to race. They're here to win. And that's something that we all have to deal with. But you know, I do feel very sorry for you, and I don't think I have anything more to add, because you know, I can tell that this is a lot to take for you. So I'll just say that, you know, it was a great season, and you know, congratulations on the constructors. I know that's not going to be too much of a comfort for you right now, but you can be proud of the way you've driven, and we really hope to see you back again, challenging again in season 13 and beyond. Seafreeze, do you have anything to add?
Oh man. Well, I wish I could come over there and give you a hug. I'm not much of a hug guy, but I give you a hug. Is there anything? I feel like you did everything right. Is there anything you think going back initially? Do you think you wish you would have done differently, or you think you really left it all out there on track? And then, and to second that, throughout the season, is there any other moment where you might look back on and say, well, if I would have done this differently, this would have happened? Or, I mean, I'm sure every driver can do that, because, you know, I could even say that for myself. If every race went correct, I'd be a 12-time champion. You know what I mean? So what do you think as far as anything differently could have been done, or throughout the season as well?
Yeah, I mean, I had a couple of connection issues throughout the season. Lost out on a bunch of points in Zandvoort. Was really quick, but I had a horrible connection, so I got disconnected from that one. There was another race earlier in the season where we had a disconnection. So, yeah, I mean, going back, looking at it, there was definitely a couple of moments where I possibly could have done a little bit better. You know, my internet could have done me a favor. But like you said, you know, there's always something that can be improved on. And that's something that I'm definitely going to try and, you know, do in the next season, try and improve on whatever I had wrong this season. But other than that, I mean, you know, I really couldn't have done anything else today. I got pole position, I had the pace, I was pulling out a bunch of you know, time on the cars behind. First safety car came out and kind of played into my hand. You know, it just saved me my medium tires. I was gonna take those until the end of the race and just do a one stop. And then that second safety car, I feel like it kind of hurt me. It did help me out to put my softs on and take it until the end. But I feel like most of the grid would have been doing a two-stop if that second safety car didn't come out. And then if I would have been able to survive with whatever gap I had on that medium tire, it could have gone differently. But again, you know, can't really play it back right now. There's nothing I can do. But again, I'm just going to learn from this. I hopefully, the other drivers involved learn from this as well, and hopefully we can improve in season 13.
Absolutely, well said. And we are not going to be hearing from Valid, but from a few messages in chat for those viewing. I'll just say that he went for it and he got it. He's trying to claim second for his constructors in the Aston Martin. So I guess that would be somewhat of his response in the interview. And we haven't been able to get an interview with Sir Charles, the champion, since he is not here tonight. But another congratulations to him and McLaren on a great season. Like I said earlier in the stream, we've had multiple race winners in this class, a lot of unbelievable races and moments, and for it to come down to the final race and such a spectacle is a great thing. So that's it for me. I'll hand it over to you, Chatty, and just a shocking end to the season, I guess.
Yeah, thanks, Seafreeze. Shocking. Absolutely dramatic. Gut-wrenching or unbelievably exciting, depending on which side of the McLaren garage you are based on in terms of support or which driver you are. But, wow. I mean, I've been doing commentary for Silver Class since season 10 now, and I think you mentioned earlier, Seafreeze, the Silver Class doesn't disappoint, and once again, just proving that tonight, full range of emotions on display, and what an incredible finale to season 12 in the Silver Class. And thank you so much to everybody for watching the race tonight. And we've had a lot of comments, obviously, with what happened. Congratulations to Sir Charles. He wasn't here, but he has won the championship courtesy of the result tonight. And he's had a brilliant season, won more races than anyone else. In a season where the wins have been quite spread out, he managed to get three victories and a few podiums as well, which has ultimately secured him top spot. So congratulations to Charles. You deserve it. Congratulations to McLaren on the constructors, and thank you to all the drivers for such a memorable season. Thank you to a few people who have done commentary over the course of this season. Obviously, Seafreeze has been here tonight and at Monaco with the campfire that we had. thanks to Captain Blade. He's been around for a few races. Perry as well, another name that comes to mind. Thank you to all the officials and everyone involved in TCR. Thanks to Fanatec, our affiliate sponsor for the league. You can use a link down in the and buy any racing gear from those guys and contribute to